It's a big win coming in right there for security forces. Wanted terrorist Abdul Hamid Lalhari was killed in Avantipora in Jammu and Kashmir. Lalhari was acting on the as a self-styled chief of Ansar Ghazwat ul Hind, an Al-Qaeda affiliated in Kashmir. The terrorist succeeded Zakir Musa as the head of the terror group a few months ago. He was gunned down along with two other terrorists yesterday. Our forces have now wiped out the entire Zakir Musa gang that's been trying to create unrest in the valley for the last many years. These terrorists have been gunned down since Musa's elimination in Thral in 2019 of May. In all 11 terrorists, part of the Ghazwat ul Hind have been neutralized. The group was affiliated with Al-Qaeda and was behind multiple attacks on security forces in Kashmir. They were also behind the September 2018 Jalandhar blast. The group also radicalized several youth in the valley, and with all the terrorists being eliminated, it comes as a massive shot in the arm for our armed forces.
Operation jo Thral mein hua, Rajpura gaon mein. त्राल में जिसमें तीन मिलिटेंट मारे गए, शुरू में इतला थी कि एक लोकल तो पहचान लिया था, दूसरे दो पाकिस्तानी या फॉरेन टेररिस्ट होने की इतला थी, मगर देर रात को बाकी दो की भी पहचान हो गई। ये तीन के तीन लोकल मिलिटेंट हैं और तीन के तीन ही अंसार गजतुल हिंद के साथ वाबस्ता हैं। आपको याद होगा जब जाकिर मूसा मारा गया था, उसके बाद इस ग्रुप की कमांड जो है वो हमीद ललिहारी को दी गई थी। हमीद ललिहारी तब से लेकर के इस ग्रुप को चला रहा था और काफी लोगों को उसने मोटिवेट किया, जबकि उस वक्त ये ग्रुप खत्म ही हो गया था। उसके बाद इसने मोटिवेट करके दो और लोग हैं जिनको मिलिटेंट्स की सफों में शामिल किया, खासतौर पे अपने ग्रुप के अंदर शामिल किया, जिसमें नवीद और जुनेद शामिल हैं।
All right, Ashraf Wani joins us live for the very latest. Ashraf, it's a very big win coming in right there for our security forces as Zakir Musa's successor has been killed. And what a big win, because the entire gang has now been eliminated by our security forces. If you could walk our viewers through the latest developments coming in the valley.
Chitti, basically, Hamid Lalhari was one of the long surviving militant commanders here in the Kashmir Valley. Security forces were looking for him since 2016 when he became the militant. Since then, he carried out many attacks on the security forces with help of other militant organizations. Even the DGP Jammu and Kashmir Police, Dilbagh Singh, said that the Jaish and the Ansar Ghazwat ul Hind were working now together in the Kashmir Valley. So that is why the security forces believe it as a major success against the militants in the Kashmir Valley. And not only that, but even Hamid Lalhari, who was the successor of Zakir Musa, was able to motivate more youths in the Kashmir Valley to merge them inside his group. So, so security forces now believe that this Al-Qaeda affiliated Ansarul Ghazwat ul Hind group has been completely wiped out in the Kashmir Valley, and there is no any more militant of the organization. So that is why the security forces believe it the big achievement. Now, another point which was taken by the Director General Police Dilbagh Singh, he said that still some youths are missing since 2019 after abrogation of Article 370, but the rate of the inclination towards the militancy of the local youths is at decline. So that is why the security forces believe it as a major success, particularly after the abrogation of Article 370, when there were so many perceptions that probably there may be the increase in the militant related incidents. But so far security forces have achieved and succeeded in curbing these acts in the Kashmir Valley.
All right. On a day when Pakistan took diplomats and journalists for a tour to Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, two people were killed while protesting in Muzaffarabad city of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir on Tuesday. Various political parties under an all independent parties alliance in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir called for a pro-freedom rally in Muzaffarabad on the occasion of 22nd of October, the day when Pakistani forces invaded Jammu Kashmir in the year 1947. Protesters raised slogans against Pakistani army. With the anger spilling out on the streets, Pakistani forces resorted to lathi charge to quell dissent. Meanwhile, Baloch families held a protest in Quetta city in front of Quetta Press Club. Relatives of Baloch missing persons demand the release of their loved ones. And India Today has accessed the details of autopsy report of Hindu Samaj leader Kamlesh Tiwari, who was brutally murdered in Lucknow. The report says that Kamlesh was stabbed with a knife 15 times and his throat was slashed twice. Kamlesh Tiwari was also shot at and a 0.32 pistol cartridge was found in the back of his head. In a major development, Gujarat ATS arrested the two alleged killers of Hindu Samaj leader Kamlesh Tiwari. The two 34-year-old Ashfaq Hussain and 27-year-old Moinuddin Pathan were held by the ATS or the anti-terror squad from Gujarat-Rajasthan border. The cops claim that both the suspects have confessed to killing of the Hindu leader by slitting his throat and shooting him. The duo had assumed fake Hindu identities and forged Facebook IDs to gain access to Kamlesh in a bid to kill him. Cops have said that Kamlesh Tiwari's objectionable remarks in 2015 were the reason. Both the accused have been sent to four-day custody.
How do you see this whole episode, the nabbing of these two main accused, Ashfaq and Moinuddin?
You know, the fact that the whole case was worked out within a record time of 4 days clearly shows that there was a very excellent coordination between various agencies, number one. Number two, we carried out a very fine example of investigative skills. Number three, that we had a lot of pressures on the accused. And number four, there was a sense of fear amongst the criminals, and that is why they were all the time on the run. And this could be possible only because of the sustained efforts that we made, the UP police made. Needless to say that we had excellent cooperation from Gujarat police, from Maharashtra police, from all the police agencies. And we did crack the entire episode within 4 days. If you recall it very clearly, that on the very first day, we had picked up, in a joint operation with Gujarat police, three criminals who had been behind this killing. And they were brought to Lucknow. They were interrogated massively. And on the basis of their interrogations, certain clues were obtained. We tried to connect those dots. We sent and dispatched our teams. We immediately constituted a SIT led by an IG rank officer. And due to a number of trails, they could be electronic in nature, they could be physical in nature, they could be circumstantial evidences in nature. But all that pointed out that a finest example of investigative skill is being carried out by UP police, and we left no stone unturned. In fact, right from day one, we had been working on this theory that we were keeping all options open, whether it was a self-motivated group, whether it was a radicalized group, whether they had any connections with the terror organizations. All these aspects were being looked into by the investigating officers.
It is Gujarat ATS that has caught them, and credit goes to them. Do you agree?
Of course, I give credit to Gujarat police. I have already complimented the Gujarat DGP, and not only that, I have complimented all my interstate agency people. The fact remains that Gujarat has done an excellent job, but at the same time, I would like to compliment my own people, my own SIT, led by the IG, Mr. Bhagat. Very painstakingly, in a very sustained manner, he collected all those evidences.
Clearly, you are indicating that they might have been encountered in UP.
No, I don't say, because our first priority is to arrest them. The first priority, but if they would have exchanged fire, then perhaps we would have taken a very extreme step. But at the same time, I must say that all the democratic means were a very fine example of policing.
It was fear in their mind?
Could be, I don't know. Let them come and then we'll interrogate. But that nature of policing that we have, we are quite aggressive towards criminals, and that could have weighed in their minds. Perhaps they would have gone back to Gujarat, because they belong to Gujarat, they had their families there, they might have felt more comfortable there. But the fact that we put a lot of pressures on everyone, on all the accused, clearly indicate that they were on the run. And I must compliment the Gujarat police for having done and having carried out such a beautiful operation to catch these people.
Had they gone to Nepal or the other states, which was being talked earlier?
I wouldn't know that whether they crossed the border, but whatever it may be, let the sustained interrogation be over, and then after that we can share the information with
them. When they are being brought to Lucknow?
They'll be coming today. My team has already reached there. They're in touch with Gujarat police. They'll be filing the reports there, and the custody remand, transit remand, everything will be taken today itself.
Kamlesh Tiwari's family has slammed the UP police and has alleged lapses in probe. The family is not demanding a death sentence, not only demanding a death sentence for the killers, but they're also demanding for the suspects to be produced before them for identification. The family has also questioned the police on how the killers escaped after murdering Kamlesh in broad daylight.
हम यही कहना चाहते हैं कि पकड़ा है तो ठीक है, हम संतुष्ट हैं, लेकिन पूरी तरह से नहीं संतुष्ट हैं।
अच्छा, डीजीपी साहब तो यूपी के कहते हैं कि उन्होंने बड़ी मेहनत की, उनकी टीम ने, इसी वजह से भाग करके वो लोग गुजरात गए, क्योंकि यहाँ पुलिस पकड़ लेती है, इसलिए वहाँ भाग के गए।
भागने ही क्यों दिया, दिन का काम था, 11 बजे दिन में उनका मर्डर हुआ है, क्यों भागने दिया? आग की तरह उनकी खबर फैली और कैसे गुजरात पहुंच गए जो आपने भागने नहीं दिया? क्या विदेश भेजना चाहते तो नहीं भेज पाए?
हमको उनकी शिनाख्त चाहिए, लेकिन उठा के उनका कपड़ा हमको दिखा दिया जाए, हम लोग 24 घंटा टीवी देखते रहते हैं, हम देख लेंगे, हम पहचान जाएंगे, हमारे जो भी देखे हैं बस लड़के लोग वो अपना पहचान जाएंगे।
क्या अभी आपको लगता है कि सही केस नहीं पकड़ा गया, ऐसा कुछ लगता है?
90% हमको पूरा यकीन है वही है, लेकिन हम एक बार उनको चेहरा देखना चाहते हैं,
पुख्ता करना चाहते हैं। आप
पुख्ता करना चाहते हैं?
अगर ये पकड़े गए तो इनके फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट में जल्द से जल्द इनकी पेशी लगा के इनको फांसी की सजा हो, और इनके शिनाख्त, पहले तो इनको शिनाख्त करवाया जाए कि हाँ यही हैं, उसके बाद इनकी फांसी हो। शुरुआत में तो लापरवाही यूपी पुलिस की थी सर, बहुत ज़्यादा थी, ये तो हम धन्यवाद देना चाहते हैं मीडिया वालों का सर, जो इन्होंने इतना दबाव बनाया, वरना आज ये कुछ ना हो पाता। और ATS का सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहते हैं। अब यूपी पुलिस से और इस यूपी सरकार से, योगी सरकार से हमारी एक ही मांग है, उनको फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट में जल्द से जल्द सर उनकी पेशी लगा, उनको फांसी हो जाए सर।
Shivinder now joins us on the story for the very latest. Shivinder, the family is now going ahead and questioning how the UP police and how did the killers manage to flee from the state after the heinous murder in broad daylight. The family going on, of course, to allege lapses on the part of the cops. Has the UP police responded to it thus far? And were there any lapses by the Uttar Pradesh police in this case?
Well, this is big embarrassment for UP police that they are lagging behind in this case since very beginning. Gujarat ATS not only arrested main conspirators earlier in this case, and also they arrested these two main accused, Ashfaq and Monuddin, last night. This raised serious question on UP police working, because they were giving CCTV footage and details of movement, that where they are hiding and what they are trying to get help from, but they could not arrest them and they ran away to Gujarat, and finally ATS Gujarat arrested them last night. Now UP ATS, UP police and UPSTF will take handover of these two accused and question further. But in the meantime, ATS Gujarat will certainly try to get information from these two main accused, that what was the whole conspiracy and who all are involved in this case. And till now, during the investigation, they have learned that this was pre-planned and long-awaited plan by these accused in this Kamlesh Tiwari murder case, and they had this conspiracy with others who were helping from outside and facilitating things for this murder. And now all onus on UP police to get new and fresh details so that they can reveal whole conspiracy, and that is big challenge for them, so that they can save their face, because this is matter of big embarrassment, not for UP police but for UP government also, because they were denying that any lack in this case. They were claiming that they will certainly do something, which is going to be very strong message for these accused, but it seems that they are not being able to do anything which is concrete in this case.
One of India's most decorated captain, Sourav Ganguly, has taken charge as 39th president of BCCI today at its AGM. This will end the 33-month reign of the Supreme Court-appointed Committee of Administrators. Ganguly, along with Home Minister Amit Shah's son, Jay Shah, and MOS Finance Anurag Thakur's brother, Arun Dhumal, took charge of the new BCCI, as they are all standing unopposed for their respective posts. However, Ganguly, along with Jay Shah, will have a curtailed tenure of around 9 months because of the mandatory cooling-off period. With Ganguly taking over, it will be interesting to see how his cricketing policies on Mahinder Singh Dhoni's international future, the selection panel, day-night tests and permanent test centers really pan out.
एक ही चीज है, क्रिकेट के भले के लिए, क्रिकेटर्स के भले के लिए, हिंदुस्तान के भले के लिए काम करें, ये हमारी अपेक्षाएं हैं। और मुझे उम्मीद है कि जय शाह और सौरव गांगुली की टीम अपने बाकी साथियों के साथ इस काम को अंजाम देंगे, बहुत अच्छी तरह अंजाम देंगे।
बीसीसीआई में एक नए युग की शुरुआत हो रही है, जो हमारे राज्य संघों के प्रतिनिधि हैं वापस फिर से आए हैं, और सौरव गांगुली जैसा नेतृत्व है जो इंडिया के सफलतम कैप्टन थे, बाकी हमारे जो पदाधिकारी हैं, जय शाह जिन्होंने गुजरात में बहुत अच्छा काम किया, बीसीसीआई में पहले से आ रहे हैं 9 साल से, अरुण ठाकुर बीसीसीआई में पहले आ रहे हैं, हिमाचल में उन्होंने अच्छा काम किया था, और हमारे जो कुछ नए प्रतिनिधि भी शामिल हुए हैं जिनमें उपाध्यक्ष भी हैं, ज्वाइंट सेक्रेटरी भी हैं, तो मुझे लगता है एक अच्छा कॉम्बिनेशन ही आया है जो निश्चित रूप से भारतीय क्रिकेट को बढ़ाएगा।
Pore Majumdar now joins us on the phone line to give us a perspective on the recent changes that have taken place at the top rank at the BCCI, with Sourav Ganguly taking charge, Jay Shah becoming the secretary as well. Borya, how do you see the lay of the land change with Sourav Ganguly taking over? It's going to be very interesting to see where he stands as far as whether the Dhoni's retirement is concerned, Dhoni's international future is concerned, I beg your pardon, the selection panel, day-night tests, permanent test centers, and what have you?
You know, you've just mentioned 3 points yourself, which actually answers the question quite beautifully. All these things are related to cricketers. You know, let me first tell you, what was Sourav Ganguly wearing today? He was wearing the 2003 World Cup blazer that he wore as captain of India to South Africa. He was carrying his laptop in a backpack, just like the current day, modern day young executive going into work. When have you seen a BCCI president carry his own laptop, wearing an Indian blazer, stepping into the BCCI office? That is the change of guard. Frankly, what is the BCCI? It is a body that is meant for cricketers, by cricketers, to empower cricketers, and exists for the empowerment of the Indian cricket fans. The two core constituents are the cricketers and the fans, and both were losing out. It is the job of Sourav Ganguly and his team to empower them both. And knowing Sourav for the longest time, he is still a cricketer first and administrator later. He will do every bit to empower Indian cricketers and fans. Now, if you ask me, there's a lot going around in terms of vendetta. What will happen to Sourav Ganguly, Ravi Shastri relationship? What will happen to MS Dhoni? Will Sourav still do something, you know, which is looked upon as retaliation for what happened in 2007-8. Let me tell you categorically that word vendetta and witch hunt can be thrown out of the window. It will be done exactly as a BCCI president should deal with an Indian captain and a head coach, and MS Dhoni as a legend of the game who has served Indian cricket. I am delighted, and I said this on Rajdeep Sardis, I showed the day Sourav was elevated to this position 10 days back when he was almost decided to take over, that I live in hope. Having interacted with Sourav at 7 a.m. this morning, I can tell you that his vision is every bit about empowering the Indian cricket fan and the cricketer, and this word vendetta has nothing to do with it. It will all be about on-field performance. If India performs, if Ravi performs, if Virat performs, Sourav performs as BCCI president, and no one knows that better.
All right, Borya, getting us a perspective right there. And Borya, you know, this whole bit about Jay Shah also being the secretary as well. How do you now look at the revised top brass of the BCCI?
You know, again, I mean, I come back to the core issue. I come back to the core issue that this is a young team, this is a new team. What are the expectations? The expectations are actually humongous from Sourav, from Jay, from Arun Dhumal, and from the rest of the people. But at the same time, they're not carrying baggage. They will have to take Indian cricket forward. You've now asked me an administrative question at three levels. One, ICC. Indian cricket's relationship with the ICC is frosty. Everybody knows that. There's a bit of confrontation. Will they take the blackmail line? My answer is no, they will not. Knowing both of these people, will they go into the confrontation mode straight away? The answer is no. At the same time, they are keen and determined to make sure that Indian cricket gets the respect it deserves and gets the money that it deserves from the ICC.
All right.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.